Hi everyone, my name is Chelsea and I'm an educator with the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. And today we're paddling on a freshwater tidal wetland on the Hudson River Estuary. So an estuary is where freshwater meets saltwater. And so if we were to follow this water upstream, we would eventually be at the mouth of the Enderkill, which is a tributary or a stream that flows into the Hudson. And if we were to follow the water this way, we would eventually meet the Hudson River. But today we're talking about freshwater tidal marshes. And this is a really unique, special habitat that we can find all along the Hudson River estuary shorelines. And actually, our own Hudson River National Estuarine Research Reserve does a lot of work monitoring and restoring wetlands just like this. So if you look behind me, you can see that the vegetation or the plants are kind of growing in different zones. And so the reason for this is that this freshwater tidal marsh is tidal. So the same tides that affect the Atlantic Ocean that rise 2 times during the day and fall 2 times also affect this wetland. So 2 times during the day, the water will rise and cover up some of these plants and it will fall and expose them to the air. Because the water level changes in the wetland so consistently, or 4 times a day, different species of plants have adapted to live at different elevations. So you can see that some are emerging out of the water, like this spatterdock here, and some, as you move further up the shore, are completely out of the water, like the cattails behind me. And although they have different microhabitats, different elevations, all of their roots are exposed to wet soil. Freshwater tidal wetlands like this one are extremely biologically diverse. And what that means is there's a really wide variety of things, living things, that live here. And I picked some of our favorite plants out of the wetland. And these are examples of the 3 zones that we can find in the wetland. So higher up, at the higher elevations, we have our really beautiful cattail, or our hot dog plant. And as you move closer to the water, we start finding plants like dotted smartweed, and burr reed, this really beautiful plant with interesting seed pods. So these actually break apart into little seeds. And then as you move in toward the water at lower elevations, we start seeing these broad-leafed plants like the arrow arum with these really large fleshy leaves. And so the wetland is not only home to this wide variety of plants, but there are several birds, insects, mammals, reptiles, all classes of animals that use this wetland for habitat, to find food. And not only is it home to these plants and animals, but it's also extremely important to humans. It provides a buffer between the land environment and the aquatic environment, the water. And so when we have heavy rains that might overwhelm our river system, or when we have storm surges coming in from the Atlantic Ocean that might make water levels rise, these wetlands act as a buffer to reduce flood and to reduce damage on our shorelines. It just holds the water. And so that works when water's moving into the system. When we have water moving out of the system, when it rains and all of that water from the watershed is moving down toward our river and eventually the Atlantic Ocean, these wetlands act as filters, filtering pollutants and contaminants out of the water before it reaches those major waterways. Thanks for joining us on this beautiful freshwater tidal wetland. I hope you had fun learning about it. And check out more of our virtual river series. Bye, everyone.